Titusville. This stop has kind of turned into a place to get done a bunch of boat projects and to do a bit of provisioning in anticipation of our Bahamas crossing, which is coming up, I don't know, in the next 2, 3, 4 weeks, something like that. Currently, Tambi and I are each working on our own boat project. Tambi, tell them what you got going on here.
I am making a hammock of sorts for the closet to put our clothes bags on.
This is going to be one hammock. And what we're doing is this is our closet over here. Let me see if I can get a better angle of this. And it's a pretty good space, but there's just no real storage. Tambi and I and Molly, we each have a set of three of these little zipper bags. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put in three of these hammock shelves, you know, 1, 2, 3, and then that way at least we each have our own hammock shelf. And then down below is where we're gonna put our shoes, because currently our shoes are just piled in this here milk crate and it's kind of in the way. So that's one project that is happening. Project two is I am working on fixing this port light in particular. Has a leak, and I'm going to be taking this port light out and installing this new port light. This is a newfound metals port light, I believe it's called. Actually came with the boat. One of them is already installed over here. It's very nice. So we're gonna put this matching one over here on this side. Out, that wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Now I just have this gaping hole in the side of our boat. Let's see, this is one of the joys of living on a boat, is or at least living on a small boat, is that all of your tools and stuff is just in a bag like this. Ah, that should help. Let's see, I'm trying to find it. Ah, let's see. Trying to find this here razor blade thing.
Okay, you have it roughly clamped into place. You're gonna measure to the top.
Now that I'm halfway into this project, I'm trying to figure out how to finish it. All right, the port light is installed. There she be. Only took me about 3 hours to do that. If you notice here, Tambi's project is largely at the same stage it was 3 hours ago. Tambi, why are the shelves not done?
Because I had to help you.
Oh, that's right. Hi. Do you remember where we are? Do you know the name of this place?
No.
It starts with an M.
St. Simon's River?
Close. We're in Melbourne, Florida. And while we were here, or I guess prior to our arrival, we had an Amazon shipment dropped here at Tambi's relative's house. And one of the items we ordered was this here EPIRB. Molly, can you explain what an EPIRB does?
Well, it calls if you need help, it calls someone.
Yeah? Like the policeman?
No, like the Coast Guard.
Coast Guard, yeah. All right, so this was something we wanted to go ahead and get before we headed over to the Bahamas. Just in case, this is good a good piece of safety gear to have. We also got some new dock lines. We've been told by multiple people that the dock lines we're currently using are too wimpy. They're like half this diameter. But yeah, that's one of those just dumb newbie mistakes we made. Our dock lines were not adequate enough for the job. And yeah, you know, we're not doing anything particular in Melbourne. We're just kind of hanging out here for a few days, visiting with Tambi's family, installing this here EPIRB somewhere in the boat. And I have to pick up a new VHF antenna and a new VHF antenna wire. Anything else you want to say to the people? Any deep, insightful, meaningful thoughts that you want to share?
If you want to see the test button, it does a cool thing in here.
Oh, okay. All right, here. All right, hold down the button. One, two, okay. All right. Okay, that's good. 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 And blink. All right. That means it's good to go. Mm-hmm. Good job, safety officer.
West Marine, Molly.
West Marine.
What do you think the total's going to be?
How much was the antenna?
So Tambi's guess on this stuff was going to be $425, and the total ended up being $427.
That's right.
Nice job, Tambi.
Price is right, that stuff.
It's amazing how much this stuff costs. This is antenna cable, by the way, if I didn't say it already. Our VHF antenna is not working. The antenna at the top of the mast was just complete garbage. The antenna itself, the antenna wire itself, was just so dry rotted, and just the shielding or the insulation was so bad that it just made sense to replace it. So not real happy about spending that kind of money on this stuff, but hey, gotta have a VHF antenna before you set off for the Bahamas.
Gotta be safe.
Almost stole those connectors. I put them in my pocket when I was in the store, but being the good Samaritan that I am, I'm going into West Marine to pay for these.
What happened?
I stole these from you. Thanks again.
Good luck.
All right, take care.
Thank you.
All right, paid for the connectors. My conscience is clear. Tambi wanted me to just run for it while I had the chance, but. All right, so what you see here, this is from a Walmart trip and the stuff that we got from West Marine. The funny thing is, we have absolutely no idea where to put all of this stuff because our boat is effectively full at the moment, right?
Yeah.
We've actually tried not to buy too much stuff. It's just, it's a hard place to find the middle ground, because on one hand, if you're going to the Bahamas, you want to buy everything that you can in the States because it's going to be just so much cheaper. And there's going to be loads more selection. In the Bahamas, it's very limited selection and it's more expensive. But on the other hand, you don't want to fill up your boat to the point where it either A, is so full you can't move around, or B, it's so full that it sinks. Really hate climbing to the top of this mast. Okay, so here's the old antenna wire. See it right there with the knot in it? All right, here's the antenna. It's a Shakespeare 4200 squatty body. It reminds me of a girl I used to know. bad news. We're feeding the wire in the top, or I'm feeding the wire in the top. Tambi can't seem to pull the wire through down below. So, I don't really know what that means. I mean, I guess on the inside of the mast there could be wires that are bundled together and like zip tied or something like that. This has been a day of defeat. I cannot get the wire run inside the mast because, for one thing, the old wire, I guess it's in conduit or something. It's just, it won't slide. It won't slide from the top. It won't slide from the bottom. And we tried dropping a new wire down the mast that we could use to, you know, run the new wire. And I can't find the hole that's between the mast and the compression post. So I don't have a way to, I was up there for 3 hours trying to drop that wire down. I just can't find where the hole is for the wire to go through. Anyways, not a great day, but we'll figure it out. What I've had to do is I've built this little L bracket, which I've mounted the antenna to. And the solution I have is that we are going to put that bracket underneath. I've almost got the antenna fixed. Please, 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 please. Radio test. Radio test. So still not perfect news. The radio is transmitting. Radio test. So it's transmitting, but it's not receiving. Here, you do it.
Radio test.
All right, this is just a quick little clip to let you know that we do have our VHF radio fixed, finally. And the solution actually was an entire new transceiver unit. We did replace the antenna wire, and we did replace the antenna itself, both of which had to have been original equipment to the boat. And there was a short in the wire itself. Maybe the short in the wire is what caused the old radio to fail. I don't know, whatever. But anyways, it is installed. It is working. It's a shiny black unit now instead of the white one that was in there. Yeah, we are actually good to go. Radio test.
Loud and clear from Harbor Town Marina.
Test.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Cap.
Good to go. These are my old jeans. I got a new pair of jeans, but I don't necessarily want to just throw these out. So I'm going to show you some ways that you can customize old pairs of jeans like this to get a little bit more use out of them. Jeans. Japris. Jorts. Okay. Bermuda jorts. Booty jorts. Now, you may think that's as far as you can possibly go, but it's not. I've got one more for you, and I call it the jong.